Eso de tú, 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 la foto por aquí, la foto por acá. Y tú dices, ay, I love it. I love
Tino.
It.
Y después cuando ella se ponga la... Pégase. Eso está rodando. Todavía no. Just wait for us.
So this is the downtowner. Every time you see my face, it is the downtowner. We have Mireia Kilman.
Oh my gosh. That's such a great opening.
I mean, for a woman like you, an actress, a beauty queen, every red carpet you embellish is like, wow. I would like to know, first of all, how did you get the idea of becoming an actress?
I actually started out in theater when I was younger. So I've done over 30 musical productions.
The beauty contest and all that came before that, after that, in the midst?
I always wanted to be in a beauty contest, but I was not able to do it when I was younger. And then I found out in the 1980s about a Mrs. contest. And I wanted to enter, and then I got divorced. So I wasn't a Mrs. anymore, and I couldn't do it. Then I remarried. I entered my first pageant in 2007. That was Miss Miami, and I went to compete for Mrs. Florida. I was top 10 there. I didn't win. But I just kind of got hooked into the beauty pageant. Beauty pageants are not all about beauty. It's about a platform. And a platform is an organization that you align yourself, that you're going to do volunteering with. And I aligned myself with the National Arthritis Foundation. I was a spokesperson for them. I went to Washington to lobby several years. And I was very proud of what I was able to do for the community. Then in 2009, I went to a national pageant called American Image. It was in South Carolina, and I won the national pageant. Actually, that's that big crown over there, which weighs a lot. And that was a great opportunity. I was invited to Miss Universe twice. There's something about the crown that it's not the beauty of it, but it's the opportunity that people listen to you when you have a crown on. I was also president of the GFWC Women's Club in Coral Gables. It's the General Federation of Women's Club, and it is the largest international volunteer organization in the world. So I felt like I was able to make a difference in the community. The other crown over there was Mrs. Cuba International. That was my last pageant, and that was an amazing experience. I spent a week in Chicago with amazing women from all over the world, and their stories gave me goosebumps.
Before I ask this question, I want the audience to look at our guest, Mireia, and think, don't tell us, who does she resemble, or who resembles her?
Well, I was actually in Las Vegas, and Jane Seymour was one of the judges for Miss Universe. And I met her going to the ladies' room. We had a bodyguard that kind of escorted us out. I mean, I knew it was her, but I didn't realize that we looked alike. We're washing our hands and we look in the mirror and she said, oh, she goes, you kind of look like me. And I said, well, you kind of look like me. We talked and she was very, very nice. And as we walked out, I asked the security guard to take a picture of us.
What was your next step in your acting career?
In 2007, I started doing film. I kind of got the bug to change from theater, and then I loved it. So film was first, and then I did a lot of telenovelas in Telemundo, and the opportunity was there. I got an agent, and little by little, I started to know a lot of directors in the film community. I've been in so many films that I'm just very proud of.
In LA, in Los Angeles, there is this game, it's called 7 Degrees of Kevin Bacon. Here in Florida, it's 7 Degrees of Mireia Kilman, because she puts us in contact with everybody. How do you meet so many people?
I think it's by attending, you know, film events and premieres and networking. It's amazing what networking can do.
I think Woody Allen once said that 90% of success is showing up.
That's correct. Very correct.
What are your projects on the table?
Well, I've been very proud that I've been in a couple of feature films by Jerome Anthony Larkin. And the first film, I had a very small role called The Life Exchange. And then the second film, I was the lead, and it was Love and Contempt, and that went on to win awards, and I was nominated along with my lead actor for the Best Actress Award at the Widescreen Film Festival. Then we did Racist Rights, also with Tony Larkin. And recently, now a movie that's getting into the film festivals and winning is a movie called Evils of a Foster Child. And I play the social worker.
A very nice social worker.
Well, you'll have to see the film. I have a short film in Spanish called La Bruja from Juliana Duque, which is a very excellent script. And also I have a film that's going to be filmed in Orlando by Dominica Angelica, and that doesn't have a title yet, but that's a very exciting script. I am doing a theater production called The Teachers Lounge.
We are doing in this program, we are now helping people. Who killed Laura Palmer? Do you know anything about Laura Palmer?
No, I don't.
It just came out in the news. So it's the T-shirt lounge?
No, the T-shirts. T-shirts.
Forget about the T-shirt.
It's about this very realistic story about teachers and students. You just have to go see it. It's directed by Passion Roosevelt.
What do you find the most challenging?
Making yourself into a chameleon that the directors can see the different characters that you could play and not typecast you.
And now I'm gonna show you a movie we did together. Look at this.
Grandma! Same thing he did to you. What's the big deal? I don't want to have anything to do with that.
How did you get into that role?
I wanted the audience to see the pain, but also, you know, she's not a very nice person, but she had her reasons.
I want to show people the Meryl Streep of Florida.
So imagine you are in this movie. What did you tell her?
Darling, John will never leave me for you. You're nothing but just a cute lawn, darling. At the end of the day, brunettes with money have more fun.
And this gown, I mean, tell me about it.
Well, this gown is kind of special for me because this was my first gown for my first pageant, and actually it was made by Carlos Alberto. He's a famous designer in Puerto Rico, and he custom made it for me.
For you. Wow. Carlos Alberto. You see what you brought to our show? Well, thank you very much again for coming to our show, and thank you for watching.